Albert Einstein said, "Pure logical thinking cannot yield us any knowledge of the empirical world. All knowledge of reality starts from experience and ends in it." The launch of James Webb Telescope is expected to empirically enhance our understanding of the physics of the cosmos. Webb is designed to enhance our knowledge by experience of observation. To Einstein, it is fundamental to our understanding. So, this is what Webb will prove from Einstein's theories and equations. 1. Looking back in time. To look back into time, we must observe the most distant events in space, because light takes time to traverse the intervening space. As the universe continues to expand, light emanating from distant events that happened billions of years ago away not only gets enormously redshifted, but also dims down to occasional photons reaching us from a dark patch of the sky. The observational power of James Webb is such that it can detect infrared signature of a bumblebee as far as the moon. At 6.5 meters across, compared to the 2.5 meters of the Hubble telescope, its light-collecting primary mirror has an area of almost 9 times the size of the Hubble telescope, and is almost 100 times more powerful. 2. Hubble's law and tension. Edwin Hubble proved in 1924 that there is no fixed center of the expanding universe, and that galaxies are moving away from each other at a speed that is only proportional to the distance between them. Advances in cosmology have made it possible to theoretically arrive at the value of H0 from data of the time soon after the Big Bang, and also to measure its value by empirical observations. The SHOES, or shoes seam, as they say, has made direct measurements in the near universe up to 2 billion light years, but prediction based on the CMB data is indirect testimony from the distant past. There's no reason to suspect the accuracy of measurements within the admitted range of small error, and the Hubble tension must be resolved with physical explanation. So here are the possible candidates: a new relativistic particle, a neutrino that interacts with radiation under suitable circumstances, dark energy that was present in the early universe, which is a different behavior of cosmological constant, or changing the value of a physical constant like the mass of electron. Thirdly, the Big Bang. How deep will James Webb look? Between 240,000 and 380,000 years after the Big Bang, the universe cooled to about 30,000 Kelvin, approximating the Sun's surface today. At this temperature, it was cold enough for electrons to combine with nuclei to form hydrogen atoms. As the free electrons were absorbed, the universe became transparent to light, that is, photons. The photons that were released are what we see as the CMB today, and is the earliest we can observe. Known as the recombination decoupling epoch, signifying absorption of electrons and release of photons, it was followed by dark ages from 300,000 to 150 million years ago. About what we know very true, the universe was dominated by mysterious dark matter. The emergence of the universe from dark ages into the reionization epoch, with gravity taking over, ushers in the formation of first stars and then galaxies between 200 to 500 million years after the Big Bang. With its infrared capabilities, though, the James Webb Telescope is expected to observe the nurseries of baby stars and evolutions of galaxies in this period. James Webb is expected to bring in more data of direct observations of the early universe, a clue to the correct value of the Hubble constant, and consequently to the question of new physics on the horizon of science. It'll also observe formation of planetary systems and atmospheres of exoplanets in the near universe for signatures of life. Thus, James Webb has such broad capabilities that it will refine our picture of the cosmos from very early stages to the present. Although James Webb is known as a successor to the Hubble, it will also carry on from where the missions of Kepler and Planck telescopes left. So, what can we expect looking forward? We are back to Einstein's assertion with which we began this video. There are times when scientists formulate such powerful theories that the weirdest of their predictions are confirmed by meticulous experiments. Einstein's relativity falls in that category. At other times, the result of a careful experiment and/or observation, expected or unexpected, becomes the basis of a theoretical progress of the rigorous discipline of physics. Ultimately, all theories also have to pass the test of falsifiability, that is, experimental confirmation. Scientists love problems their physical theories throw up, since they become the basis of breaking novel grounds. Thus, the Hubble tension is a welcome difficulty that Webb will help resolve by extending our experience of observations. For, as Einstein said, all knowledge of reality begins and ends in experience. Thank you for watching. If you'd like to know more about Webb and its latest images of Mars, check out this video here. Otherwise, see you soon. Cheers.